All right, okay. Hi everyone. Today I'm trying something a little different. I've got this lapel mic and hopefully you can hear me better. I'm trying to figure out how to make it work. Anyway, let's see if it works. So today I want to talk about the 6 books that completely transformed my life. So let's get started. The first book I want to talk about is Stephen Covey's 7 Habits of Highly Effective People. I think he wrote this in like 89 or something like that. I discovered it in the 90s, and it was the first book that completely transformed the way I was thinking, and it kind of gave me this like desire to learn more. It was the first time I was ever really exposed to, like, let's call this like a self-help kind of book. And Stephen Covey later, I think he wrote a few other versions of that book, or he wrote about more strategies that he had, but I think this was his most popular one. So for this book, the takeaway that I got was, now keep in mind, I think I was probably 18 or 19 at the time, but my perspective from that book is that you can look at all the things that you do and all the time that you spend in your day, and you can divide that into categories of things that are really important to you and things that are less important to you. Now, without going into too much detail about his strategies, he actually has some worksheets in the book, and I found those super helpful. That's how I learn. I love those types of books where you can do exercises and you can learn through it. If you're struggling with getting more work-life balance in your life, I really recommend this book. I mean, even like 20 some years later, it's really has a lot of value. I think what it does is it helps you learn how to prioritize and how to basically save your energy. For me, that was the first time I ever thought about energy and how I was giving it away without even thinking about it. Of course, when you're 18, you don't really think, well, I have a choice here. I don't have to do this and I can do this instead. But these are really good lessons to learn, and I really recommend this book. The other book that transformed me was The Alchemist by Paulo, and I apologize if I'm saying it wrong. This book was a fictional book about a spiritual journey. And for me, what it did was connect me to this sort of spiritual place where there's meaning of life and there's something more, something greater than ourselves. And I hadn't really thought about it that way in the past. And in the story, I think there's different things that happen, and we can call them synchronicities or serendipity. But essentially, those are things that lead the main character towards their journey. So to me, that was a story about listening to your intuition, paying attention to the synchronicities around you, to the signs, in other words. So it sounds woo, but to me, that's about really paying attention to how you feel about something. So if you're in a situation and it feels good to you and you feel like this is where I'm meant to be, this is meant for me, then you're in the right direction. But if you're not feeling that way, if you're feeling like there's something more, something missing, then you have to listen to that voice. You have to start really listening to your heart. And I really recommend that book as well. So the third book I wanted to talk about is The Celestine Prophecy. The Celestine Prophecy is another spiritual book. I think at that time in the 90s, I was really questioning things. I was wondering what my purpose was in life. I was trying to figure out, you know, why I was here, what I was meant to do. And of course, when you're in your 20s, you do a lot of that. So when I read this book, it opened my eyes to the energy around us and how we can use energy and how we do use energy for good or for bad with other people. It also really sort of for me confirmed that there's such an important need to connect with nature. So in this book, they talk a lot about, I think it happens in Peru, and there's these techniques that you can use for getting energy from the environment, from the plants, and protecting yourself in that sense. So it's also, I believe, a fictional story, but it's a spiritual journey that the main characters go through. And I believe that there's actually a film that was made about it. So if you're curious about that, to look into The Celestine Prophecy, I really recommend taking a look at that book. And I believe James Redfield wrote a second book afterwards, The Tenth Insight, I think. So the book is really offering 9 insights about the world and how we can interact with other people and the environment around us. So, I mean, these books really, really transformed how I was feeling about myself and how about my life. And they helped me realize that I needed something a little bit more than just going around. And I needed, these 3 books really helped me understand that I needed to connect to something that was bigger than me. And that's actually when I started to discover meditation. So it opened me up to the idea that meditating, spirituality, that there's something there that can help you feel more happy, more fulfilled, and just more at ease with your life. So the other book that I wanted to talk about is Eckhart Tolle's The Power of Now. He actually published this book in 2001, but it became more popular when he came out with his other book, which was A New Earth, which I'm going to talk about in a minute. But Eckhart Tolle's The Power of Now has been completely transformational for me. It's still, I still learn from it. I still read it now and again. And what it did was it kind of connected the spiritual side of me with the meditation practice that I had started in my late 20s, and actually more like mid-20s, but by the time I was really seriously into it, I would say my late 20s. And The Power of Now talks about how you can learn to be in the moment and be mindful and use mindfulness. And what this does really is it takes the pain, it disconnects you from the pain from your past and from the anxiety or about the future or the fears about the future. And most of us, what Eckhart says is that most of us are in one of 3 states. We're either always thinking about our past and reliving it, or we're thinking about our future and feeling worried about it or anxious about it, but we're never quite living in the moment that we have right now. So the other state that we can have is to be in the moment, connect to the now, and enjoy what we have right now, because really there is only now. So that book was so transformational for me. I really recommend it. And to me, it's a must-see. So the other book I wanted to mention, again, was from Eckhart Tolle, is A New Earth. Now, I've talked to some family members and friends about this book, and they just didn't quite get it. So I think it's something that you're either going to love or hate. But for me, I think it was the right time in my life to discover this book. And again, it's very much based on a lot of The Power of Now's principle. But I think this book is also about how we can be within this earth, how we are connected with other people, and how our actions affect others, whether we want to or not. And to have compassion for others is part of that ecosystem. So without getting into too much about the book, I recommend reading it if it's something that you're thinking about in terms of what your place is in the world, how you can help the world be a better place, and how you can connect to others. The sixth and final book I'm going to mention is Anita Moorjani's Dying to Be Me. And this book was about her experience, which was a near-death experience. She had terminal cancer and she was in a coma, dying in the hospital. And during this experience, she says that she had conversations with God, or whoever you want to call him or her, and with other people that she had known. She also could feel the presence of people who were around her, people who were alive in the hospital. And she was very much aware of why she had become sick and how what her purpose was in the world. So this also is a very spiritual book. It's a story about learning to know what your purpose is in life. It's also just a really great story to read. Really fascinating, and I really recommend reading this book. I think it'll open your mind to the possibility that there's a connection between wellness and our health and our spirituality and also our thinking. So our thoughts can become things or experiences, whether that's good or bad. And that is what opened my mind to mindset work. After that, I mean, I discovered other books like Wayne Dyer's books and Byron Katie's books and other authors, but these books really kind of like set me on the path to opening up my mind enough that I was able to see that there was a better way of living my life. At the time, I was a very anxious person. I still have a tendency towards anxiety sometimes. But now I'm able to manage those thoughts and to question whether or not they're true. And I'm able to face those fears that I have, that everyone has about the world and our lives. And yeah, for me, these books have been so transformational. It's one of the ways that I learn, that I expand my mind. And for some reason, one book always leads to another. So now I'm on the path for my next book. So if you want to make a comment below and let me know what book you recommend for me, I would love to have your ideas. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you're not a subscriber. Thank you so much for listening, and I hope this has been helpful, and happy reading.